Hello, good afternoon everybody. I'm Avinash and we are running short on time. Already we are starting late. So we'll quickly go through the use case, the demo, and we'll cover the decisions which we have taken. After that, if the time permits, question and answer, I'll introduce myself and my work. So it's better that this one we get covered first. So the use case is about 15 billion computations on a investment portfolio. It's a firm-wide computation. And in the investment bank, what happens is you have got 3 million positions. And the positions are like, I own 10 shares of Microsoft. That is a position. You own, let's say, 15 shares of Cisco. That is a position. There are going to be, for one day, there is going to be around 3 million positions. So it's all about quantity. Position is all about how many stocks you have and what is the quantity. You could have futures, you could have many other things. The other aspect is the model. The financial market, they think what is going to be the price of this stock if there is going to rain, if the oil price is going to go up, if the gold is going to come down. So they do like 5,000, 6,000 models will be there. And then they're going to apply this, multiply for each model, what is going to be the total portfolio value. And based on that, the risk is calculated. So the business case, like 3 million into 5,000, you have to touch each and everything and calculate and find out the risk. So it's 15 billion computations. On top of that, the lookup is going to happen for each model. There's 2 million products. So it's a big 2 million into one model, then you look what is the price on that. Just imagine it's a HashMap and you are doing continuous lookup for each calculation. So it's a lookup plus calculation. Both happens now. And we want to do it in real time. The current system, which is just looking 5 days, it's not good enough. We want to see 6 months to see that how my RICS model is working. And with the current data is in the tape, so there's a big process of 2-3 days to bring it from the tape and load it and then see it. So I'm going to show you a demo also how we are doing it. Okay, let's go to the demo. Before the demo, let me show you the data, simple data. So this is a account, this is a product, and this many stocks or futures I am holding. So this is one type of data, which is all about quantity. So now I will check, okay, I will say, okay, this is the product ID, 1. Okay, holdings is 18323. Let's go to the prices. And go to the, in the model 1, there is going to be like the, 2 million of them will be there in model 1, model 2, like that there are 5,000 models I have taken. Okay, each model will look into what is the price and then we compute and make it total in the end of the day. So 5,000 models, in each model, what is my total portfolio value? So 15 billion computation. So, I have this infrastructure. The infrastructure has got 8 machines. These machines are from Amazon. And the front server where we have hosted this application is in Azure. So we have mix, Azure plus Amazon. So we hit the Azure front machine. Then we hit the cluster of the Amazon. It has got 8 CPU machines of 10 of them. And hard disk is just a regular SATA. We have EBS also there. And total memory is 300 GB. Each machine has got 30 GB, so 10 into 30 is 300 GB. Now I'm going to fire the computation. Okay. So after this, I show it quickly. We'll go to the I'll discuss about the design, and then we'll open up for the question and answer. So I'm going to run it. Whenever I'm going to run it, I'm going to start my VM start. It's going to take 40 seconds around. Okay, so the whole objective for us was to get idle time to less than 10% and maximum CPU uses, and we are running it in the 4 GB JVM. So JVM is 4 GB. We have simulated a ultra fast SSD by reading the data from the OS cache. So all the data is in the OS cache. So we read it from there. It is like acting like a ultra fast SSD. In the real production, it is like all the SSD drives are there. For this demo, I am reading it from the, I just OS cache is giving me very fast. But the JVM size is only 4 GB. It is over because I can see 100% and all the things, other things are done. So let's go ahead. Okay, the result has come and it is 44 seconds this time. Okay, these are the different models and the total portfolio value on different models got calculated. And the chart is, I mean, this is what is the rigs chart which is coming. Okay, so okay, that's fine. So now let me go and start opening up the architecture behind it. And I believe that time you can correlate a lot of things. This is if we give 64 CPU core machines and a lot of them, the millisecond performance is going to come. And I have just 8 core VMs with Amazon, those are regular AMD processors. It is coming this 40 seconds. I'm going to share with you one of the benchmarks once we do it in the Intel labs next week. So you can directly access the demo from the online and can see the findings. So the business benefit is we don't have to just work with 5-day data. They can see all the 6 months data, and that is available for the readily computing. And second is the solution is not JVM cache-based solution. It is only 4 GB JVM cache per machine for the processing. So it's only going to be like 4 into 10, which is 40 GB only. So you can see here the infrastructure, this run. My overall CPU usage is, this is a historical run, I have taken it from here. So it's like overall cluster, the CPU usage is 95 above, whereas this is actually wait time is absolutely zero. There is no IO wait. It's simulated ultra fast SSD simulated by Linux OS cache. And my idle time is almost like less than 10%. And the memory you see here is the overall memory. We have 300 GB. And this is the JVM memory we are using, which is only 40 GB across all the JVMs. And the used memory is, which is the OS cache is doing, you can see actually around 200 plus, little bit 200 plus. Okay, so let's go through. Okay, so the design. So please feel free to stop me and ask anytime the questions, because this is we are going to go through the design solutions. Our one HBase cell contains either 18 MB or 16 MB. So one key value is 16 MB or 18 MB. We don't store one string or integer or float. One big chunk we take 16 MB and we store it there. And the position table is what we, as we are processing, we slide it, like we load it, and then we just keep on passing it and keep on computing across different models. And these models gets computed, one model, okay, all these byte array, which is 16 MB or 18 MB, are binary sorted lazy deserialization we do. It's all binary sorted, and we do lazy deserialization. We never deserialize and put it into the list. We just deserialize and then look at it, or in the binary data itself, we search and find it out. So we never do like load it to the list or map and then look. We don't do that because we cannot handle the JVM if we do that. So the schema design for the positions, the key is the date. And for that date, all the positions, which are 3 million, and the total size, binary size is 18 MB, text size is 50 MB. The models, again the key is price model and value is model, the price, and all of them 2 million prices are there. It's 16 MB, and now the cross product happens between these two. So as I was mentioning, we are doing actually in one model, we are keeping all 2 million in one cell. If we don't do that, we found out in HBase, it's going to take around 500 MB for one day, actually. 500 GB for one day. For one day data, if you just load it into the HBase, it's 500 GB. And 6 months data is there. If we do all basically one model and one cell, everything in one big chunk, it is only coming to 70, 80 GB. So that much, around 80 GB it comes actually. So that much benefit we are getting. That's why we decided to load it in big chunk. The second things, why we moved away from the RAM based to SSD based. We don't want to process in RAM because the amount of garbage which is being generated and the Java process which is collecting, that equation was not good. It was generating more and more garbage than it can collect. So we come out from that and we moved into the SSD. And what we achieved, which I was showing you, 95% CPU usage and with only 4 GB JVM memory node. So we don't have any Java GC issues. We don't like GCs because we don't know how to tame them. Okay, how much we do setting, going to the cloud era, JVM specifications, how to tune it, going through all Stack Overflow, or God knows, okay, all doing our own thing. Still, we don't know how to tame the GC. So this is a big problem for us. So we said, finally, we are not going to handle GC. And disk latency, if we don't do in the RAM, then it's a disk. For the disk, we did SSD. So we are going to hook it into the SSD. So the amount of disk I/O we get, or we can read, the CPU is getting maximized. So disk is not a bottleneck with the SSD. The third thing is for this demo, I have simulated a ultra-fast SSD with Linux OS CAS. Again, it is not Java, it's operating system Linux OS CAS. So no I/O wait, no garbage collection. So GCs we don't like. I personally hate GC. The second concept which we did was we wanted to compute everything locally in parallel. Okay, it's a very big concept. Whenever I'm reading the data there is in the Hadoop, there is a DFS client which HBase is going to use and read the data. And DFS client is going to read in some chunk and chunk over the network. Though it is coming from the local node, but it is over the network. We wanted to directly read from the disk and compute and process. No intermediate network. So that we did with the short circuit. So HDFS read short circuit. You can see there is a flag called short circuit. If you do that, it's going to directly read from the local disk and just give it to you. So there is no network is coming in between. So again, no network call, no DNS lookup, complete local, as if like my program is opening a file and reading it. The second is the DFS client CAS. So we wanted all the name node locations, data block locations, it should not go to the name node and ask it. So we are casing it. And the CAS is very efficient because there are only 500 blocks. Because we are having like such a big chunk of size. So, and we have set it up in that way. It's only 500 blocks, it gets cached. So it doesn't basically make repetitive call to the name node. So everything goes local. You will see no network call, nothing. It's just local. Read the file from SSD, compute it. Okay. So this is the next thing. How we calculated our region server size. The way we wanted to process is one CPU or one core, one price model. Second core, second price model. We don't want interrupts. We don't want context switch. We don't want any of those conflicts. So our game is one core, one price model. Compute it, finish it. So the way we calculated, that's why one thread per price model, 16 MB is the size, and let's say 5,000, we have taken 5,000 models and number of CPU cores available. If we give these settings, the region server is going to be appropriately created, and one thread, one, it will go. So if this is, please wait, I wanted to show you the Intel Labs, Mukesh is not here. which should have been finished by now. Next week I'm going to finish it and going to share it with you. I'll post it there. This is all small machines. Okay, this is MapReduce architectural pattern. It's not MapReduce the way you do the job. The HBase coprocessor, we make calls to all the regions, and there is a 16 meg get processed each key value, and finally that's like we have a MapReduce kind of a pattern implemented. It is going to deserialize, going to make a call, so we process it there. So everybody knows it's very simplified API-wise. After the processing is over, everything gets again combined in the coprocessor region server level and get pushed. So it is no sorting and shuffling, which you might have seen in the last presentation, Mr. So we are not doing any sorting and shuffling, no network. It's just a API or a framework which we have introduced, because people who are coming, they're already doing MapReduce. So we have introduced the same call so that they don't have any additional learning. They just quickly go through that. So as a coprocessor gets parallelly processed, and finally we get the output. We are using internally this MapReduce, which I said real-time MapReduce, and then this byte array deserialization. There is an open source called Ssearch, which is in the GitHub. You can check it out, Ssearch core. Primarily, we are using it for the pharma. I have used it for pharma. We are using it for the financial market. We have used it for the telecom. So this one we are using a lot. And the new problem which has come to us is we have to use it for processing around 18 terabytes real time, around that, in oil wells and other things. So please check it out, this one. So this is the broad architecture. We did a feed loading, which is a search index. We do an indexer where big blocks gets cut and then getting finally returned to the HDFS. Other side, we do a real-time MR, which we process and get the data out. So we like the HBase because scalable, real-time, Apache licensed. And we did a search because it's sorted binary lazy deserialization, real-time MapReduce, and extreme parallelization. Okay. So I'm open to questions. Please shoot me. Because it has been after the launch, it's been good. Yeah.
Can you talk a little about your serialization, deserialization, and how you came up with the 18 MB sort of a size? Did you benchmark it? How do you think it played with your RAM and the way that your disk weather? Would that 18 MB change in some other situation? And one other question was, you said that you're using SSD instead of RAM. So are you deserializing and putting it on disk and then doing, what did you mean by that statement?
Okay. So 16 meg is very simple way, if you see, is one product ID and one price. So 4 byte is the product ID, 4 byte is the price, 8 byte, 2 million, 16 MB.
So could you have taken more data? Could you have put multiple product IDs with like 32 MB of chunk size? Would that have given you better?
Yes, you are correct. So for this demo, I have given that's very subjective, and we give a basically a little bit bigger size so that it doesn't get splitted. So to fit it, we can say 24 MB is the size. Cell size. So two will not fit, one will fit there. So that's how we want to process. We can make it bigger actually, it's not a problem. The only thing is then per CPU one price model computation, we have to write that parallelization logic, read it and then do it. Both also, that also we have done. We make it very big and then we read it 4 and then at one shot we'd say parallelize. And those 16 MBs, we are just the array, we refresh every time, reuse. Fill it, process it. We do that too also.
So when you deserialize, do you put it on disk?
That I want to answer the second question. No, it's not deserialized. We never deserialized. It's lazy deserialization. as I am deserializing, I am computing. Because we don't use any list inside the code. No list, no map, nothing. It should not be any list. If we do the list, again the JVM is going to come. And we hate that. So we just read it. It's like it's a visitor pattern. We give the computing to that. Inside, imagine this 16 MB. We have a visitor pattern. And the code is just continuously calling it and processing it. As it is deserializing, it's calling it.
Hi. You explained about using the direct file method to improve the speed. Is it the same HDFS? You use some parts for raw data computation and some parts for real-time computation? Or how was this speed achieved in terms of direct file?
Let me rephrase the question if I understand correctly. You are asking about the real-time and the batch, the two different things. So the way I look into this thing, the real-time configuration and the batch configurations are totally different. The real-time configuration is, so the clusters also should be different. It should not be the same cluster.
But you said about the local, right? You started using local. What is the configuration? How you improved?
Okay. There is a
or
switch.
Otherwise,
I got it.
I could use a simple file system, right? Why I need an Hadoop?
Yes.
So I just put a direct into a directory with SSD,
yes.
And I access. Then it becomes real time.
Correct. So in the new version of Hadoop and HBase distribution, you will find a configuration called short circuit. And you make it actually on or off. But the thing is, if you make it on, it still may not be available locally. So to make it available locally, you have to touch once. Okay. Or you want to basically have another way of knowing that which is in which location, which is DFS, the data block actually. You may want to have that. Otherwise, the easiest way is touch once, then you have it. The second thing is, if you restart your cluster, then only this problem comes, not the first time.
Do you have a single reduced shard? Meaning, how are you avoiding the shuffle?
It's because the way during the time of keeping the data, we have kept the whole price model at one place. So there is nothing, it's one price model and all related data never goes to the other server. That holds good. Even for the pharma industry, where one clinical study goes to one cell. Even holds good for the building energy efficiency. One building data goes to one cell. Or everywhere it is the same thing. It's a big one chunk that is become the merge key. And on that we do the grouping, distributed grouping. More questions? How much time we have left? Very good. So, okay, as we have little time, let me introduce myself. I am committer of Search, and I presented Search first time in 2011 at the Yahoo Big Data Summit in Bangalore. So that's the time we started writing it. We wrote a lot of code, but we didn't focus on the adoption side and no documentation. And nothing. But one good thing we did, when we applied it to different customer locations on different use cases, we have to make it really, really very easy for people to do it. So second thing is what use cases HSearch is addressing is distributed grouping. Solar, less than 1 terabyte, no distributed grouping. Solar is very good. More than 1 terabyte, or 1 terabyte distributed grouping, Search is very good. More than 1 terabyte, Search is very good. So this is how we are doing. It's all real time. We are only focusing on the real time nature of it, and all the language feature of the Solar, whether stemming, limitation, all is supported. Whenever we are doing the indexing, whenever we do the index, it goes into these big cells, and from there we process it. And we have given a plugin architecture where the MapReduce you can write. So you can take a moment, read it. Otherwise, if somebody come up with some questions, I'm here. After this, if you want to discuss your use cases specific design, I'll be available here also. Okay. Thank you for listening.